Well, hello there, I'm Green Deane, and welcome to my 96th video, this time about a wild fruit that everyone knows about, but very few people actually eat, wild apples. Why wild apples? Well, I'll tell you. Because most foraging books skip over wild apples completely. Why don't people eat more wild apples? There are perhaps three answers. One is, apples are a commercial product and widely available, some 55 million tons a year. But that's not really an excuse. Another is that wild apples often have worms, which, while fresh protein, bothers some folks. They can be cut out, so that's not a big deal either. A third reason is that apples are often sour or bitter. Now that's interesting because bitterness does not stop us from preparing other wild foods. The apple should be no different. Many, not all, but many wild apples can be made quite tasty just by cooking them. That cooking can be as simple as roasting them next to a campfire or boiling them. That also kills off any, you know, creatures that might be inside. But you can also soak any wild apple in salty water to get rid of any creatures. You know, I've even seen campers take domesticated apples into the woods rather than try a wild apple. That's bizarre. Let's go look at some apples. This is a cultivated apple. It's a descendant of a wild apple found in Kazakhstan. Apples there have been looking like this for about 6,000 years. And unlike modern apple species, the apple trees that are still in Kazakhstan are fairly disease-free. There are between 7,500 and 10,000 different kinds of domestic apples. England claims to have the most. The United States has about 7,000 of them. There are between 25 and 30 wild apple species worldwide, and about 7 of those species in the United States. The apples you meet in the wild can be wild domestics, they can be hybrids, or they can be true wild apples. This little nutritious nugget still grows in the wild in North America, and also around the world, and you can usually pick up all you can eat or cook. You just have to try them first to decide how to prepare them. Just because I can buy cherries doesn't mean I ignore wild cherries, and just because I can buy apples doesn't mean I ignore wild apples. Now, what about this apple, which actually, in taste, resembles a lot of wild apples? It was originally nurtured by a little old lady in Australia whose name I can't mention because of trademarks. But it was a cross between two apples that were descended from Kazakhstan. So this is actually a domestic apple, even though it's green and even though it's tart. Now, tart apples have a following, but worldwide, sweet apples prevail. If you bring more apples into your life, not only will you be healthier and have more variety, but you'll also be... Where I grew up, there are many, many wild apple trees in the woods nearby, from everything from an escaped Golden Delicious to little green natives. And I was always raiding them, them and Concord grapes. I'm surprised I didn't grow roots. My great-grandmother used to take raw apples, slice them very thin, thread them on a string, and hang them in the attic to dry. It didn't go bad, had them all for the winter. My grandmother canned apples, and my mother, well, she's 84 and eats the entire apple, core, stem, and seeds, which are called pips. When she eats an apple, there's nothing left. It's completely gone. And her mother did the same thing. Here on Eat the Weeds, we itemize. Let's itemize the wild apple, or even the domestic apple, but the wild apple. And we start with identification. It's a tree, sometimes at 20 feet high, very contorted, has a rigid crown. Branches are often spur-like. The twigs are often thorn-like. The leaves are alternating, sawtooth. They have an obvious network of veins on the top and the bottom. The flowers are pinkish to white or white. Five petal, very scented. And it will have apples. That's the important part. Usually smaller and tarter than the store-bought apples. And just to make sure, you cut the apple through right at the equator, and if you look down at it, or what we would call the equator, and look down at it, you'll see a five-shaped star, and that'll tell you that it's for certain an apple. Time of year, fall, usually, persists into the winter. If you're a hunter, a wide variety of game also visit apple trees. Now, incidentally, here in Florida, only two types of apple trees grow, and they both fruit in the late spring. Environment. Cooler climates, usually. Neither wet nor dry, likes well-drained soil, often on the south sides of hills where there are few other trees. It's a very common place to find apple trees. Also along fences and roads. Now, if that's a country woods road or something like that with very little traffic and it's dirt, well, that's not too bad, but not the interstate. Method of preparation. Roast them by a fire or in an oven or boil them. You'll have to experiment a little. If they're good raw, you can also make them into jelly, apple butter, pies, and the like. In fact, cider. See my video on making hard cider. Drying can also make some wild apples edible. In fact, they've been doing that since the Middle Stone Age. Now, apple blossoms can also be eaten sparingly, on the trail or in a salad, but not too many, just a few, because they contain sugar and cyanide bound together, which changes into hydrogen cyanide after you eat them. There are also other uses for apple wood. It's a good wood to smoke meats with. The wood can also be made into pipe bowls. When I was a kid, I used to help my father make them. You boil a piece of apple wood, you bore it from two angles, and then carve it. And it makes very nice bowls for pipes. I helped my father make several. Well, thanks for joining me here in my 96th video, this time about wild apples. If you want to know more about eating wild apples or other edible wild plants, go to eattheweeds.com. So until next time, this is Green Deane. I want you to think green. I want you to eat green. I want you to live green, but also include wild apples. You know, they ain't pretty, and they're kind of small, but they cook up nice, and they're really good for you. Doodles.